having talks about their futures until 4 a.m. And I'm happy for them. But I wanna feel all that love and emotion.
Assalamu alaikum. Alaikum Assalam.
محمد سيد الكونين والثقلين محمد سيد.
Grandma tries Arabic food for the first time.
You have to try the malakaya, it's to die for. You have to try the hawachi, it's exquisite. You should have some umami with your coffee.
And she asked too.
सोच भी नहीं सकती और अच्छे वाला मिलेगा हस्बैंड वाली फीलिंग मिलेगी तुझे क्या करना इन एक्सुक्स के पास जाके आग लगे एक्सों को
What's the matter?
Just hay fever.
Hello?
Mom?
Yeah?
Can you come get me? People are getting engaged.
Things in my Desi house that just make sense, part 2. A mom or mother-in-law watching Desi dramas, a dad or a father-in-law taking a nap, a bathroom with a lota, or if you're really fancy, a bidet, lots of durian on display or packed away in a shoebox. Shalwar kameez in every closet and a second freezer filled with meat.
Chai addiction and your mom fills your hydro flask with chai? Bro, this is a 32-ounce bottle.
As a Muslim, having this place at work is a blessing. We even have prayer clothes and rug.
Like, how do you even explain this to a coworker? Like, yeah, I'm just washing my feet. Like, just a regular day.
So I speak Arabic.
I speak Urdu, and we have 10 words that we're gonna decipher. Sabun.
Sabun.
Gari.
Sayara.
Dude.
Halib.
Pani.
Mine.
Shukriya.
Shukran.
Bye.
Ah.
Kursi.
Kursi.
Chappal.
Shahata.
Meri jaan.
Habibi.
Habibi.
What's up?
How do you say hair in Bengali? Chul.
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 Yeah, chul. Chul.
In Arabic, we say shahr.
Shahr.
Yeah. Shahr.
Shahr.
Pakistan? I thought you were from Pakistan. You know, I've actually been to your country. Beautiful country, great people. I stayed up north, actually. You're a little darker than the rest of them, ain't you, fella? I know they were gorgeous, white skin and blue eyes, just like me. They thought I was a local.
And you're women, am I right? I could take me back a couple of those ones, am I right? Am I right?
I think it's quite bizarre. You call it a bazaar. I actually bought this. Said the original price was 25,000, but I managed to bargain it down for 7,000. What? You haven't been up north? In your own country?
Wait a second, are you the tourist or am I?
Don't drink the tap water, am I right? Had to eat vegetarian. My stomach just couldn't digest your people's meat. I know I'm a high school dropout, but I think I could make good money being a teacher in your country. We were surprised people would be swimming in those canals.
Another thing about hijab, like when I started wearing hijab, I was the only person besides like one khala in my family who wore hijab. And there was no hijabis on my dad's side either. It was just me. And my khala lived in Pakistan and she like wears like a dupatta hijab. Like that's easy. I was 12 years old putting on hijab. My khalas didn't want me to put on hijab. My mom told me not to put on hijab. I don't know why I'm getting so emotional about this and why I woke up thinking about this. But like the only person who really supported me and did not have the initial reaction to be like, no. Like, my dad didn't say anything, my brother didn't say anything, but it wasn't anything like, oh, like, you're doing a great thing. My Nani Jan, who I'm really missing right now for whatever reason that I'm gonna see in like 2 weeks, inshallah. But like, she was like the one person who was like, you're doing a really good job. And like, aunties in the community would be like, why are you doing this? And wow, I have never cried about hijab, and now I'm about to post this on TikTok. This is so embarrassing. You know, I just think it's the guilt that comes with knowing that you're not perfect. And like, I'm obviously not perfect. I'm a human being. I'm never going to be perfect. But like, I want to be a better Muslim, and I want to be a better hijabi. But I really do think it's really based on intention. Like, Allah knows what you've been through. And I think it's also, I'm thinking about this because someone texted me about hijab and I just had a conversation about hijab with my friend. And like, I don't know, if you're just like thinking about putting on hijab, I think that's great. I think you should do it. It's definitely worth it. And I also really like the respect that you get from it, because like, random people know that, I don't know, it's hard to explain, but I feel like non-Muslims see that you're wearing hijab and they know that they're supposed to like behave a certain way around you. Like, they know that they're not supposed to be like super vulgar, and like they kind of see, I don't know, I find it, I like it, I love wearing hijab. Wow, I'm losing my mind. Yeah, so I don't know what the thesis of this 1 3-minute video is, but if you think about hijab, put it on, and I will support you. Even if no one else supports you, I will support you, and more than that, you know who will support you? Allah. Allah will support you, and that is all you need. Allah's support is literally all you need, because, you know, putting on hijab for Allah, you're doing it for His pleasure. You're gonna have so much blessings in it. It's gonna be so easy for you. Allah is so great, and that's all you need. Like, you don't need support of anyone. You need... And it might be hard sometimes, but just remember, like, Allah is with you. Allah is always with you.